It was a slight on my honor, so he deserved it. But we're talking about the most brilliant mind this world has ever seen.
That's a selfish want. I really don't. Well, I'm not saying that I have this capacity because it's hard to develop that capacity on your own when you're being stopped at every turn.
There's been violence in Oakley's main shopping strip as angry lockdown protesters clashed with police. The mask-free mob claims the stay-at-home orders are killing more people than they're protecting. Laura Turner was there.
Oakley's Eaton paved with aggression.
You're a f***ing bully, mate.
Their message embroiled in anger.
And nobody would answer us. So if you look around you, absolutely every single person in this line is not following the chose directive, so I think you all should be detained and fined. Citizens' arrests. Doesn't make any sense.
Like, why are they holding this gentleman's arm? Like, he's not resisting. He's not going to run.
Were the Palestinians killed in these recent riots protesters? And the answer to that is no, they're terrorists.
Lovers of freedom, and most importantly, Trumpers. My name is Steve Booth, and I thank you all from the bottom of my heart for coming along tonight to add your voice to the worldwide chorus of good, peaceful people who have had enough of the cheating, lying left, the Marxist media, and their big tech censors and bureaucrat enablers that have infested themselves within our nations. Led by George Soros and many other faceless powers, these filthy globalist scum have force-fed our people lies and rubbish for decades, and finally scared our wider societies into a worldwide hysteria. As far as I can tell, they've done this to squeeze their last bit of power out of our systems before we flush them down the toilet of history.
Hello friends, my name is Ari Therger and today I'm going to talk about the Valknut. Now, before we start, in this video there will be a lot of strange terms and names and I will place them on the screen, but please turn on the subtitles for more information. Now let's go. There are no evidences whatsoever that this symbol is called Valknut or Valknutr. Supposedly it means the knot of the slain, but such term is never mentioned anywhere. And since this name has been connected to this symbol for too long, not only for academics, but also for people who follow and practice the Northern European pagan traditions, it would be very hard to break the connection between the symbol and the term Valknut. I have written about this symbol 5 or 6 years ago at my blogs, and I have stated that there are no proper evidences to support the assumption of Valknut being a symbol connected with death, sacrifice, and even fate. But I have failed to mention that this symbol, its name is not Valknut, and its original name is simply unknown. The word Valknut does not exist in the Norse language. The term was applied to the symbol in modern scholarship, but there is no historical background to support this. However, the term is a real term. Valknut is a real word, and it comes from the Norwegian word Valknut, which belongs to an entirely different symbol. This one you can see in here. And it was used, and it's still used, on woodworking, metalworking, and on textiles to create patterns and inchins molds, as you can see in here. Valknut is probably the most known and used symbol, as well as Mjolnir, by the neo-pagans, heathens, and the people who practiced the Northern European pagan traditions. And as I've said before, the word Valknut is a neologism created by modern times, supposedly by connecting two words, Valr, the dead or the slain, and Knut, knot. And this symbol is created by the interconnection of three triangles, and these triangles can be joined in two different ways, the Borromean way and the Unicursal. The Borromean type can be seen, for instance, in the Storahammer's runestone. Everyone who knew about the original name of this symbol is now dead, and we will probably never know the real term of the symbol. This symbol is known to be associated with death and sacrifice. But is it really? Now, I will show you an image, and let's try to read that image. In this image, the Storahammer's runestone, we can see a raven, which might obviously at first be connected with the god Odin. Or is it a falcon? And you can see a burial scene in here, and even a burial mound. And there are obvious connections with death and a ritual being performed. A dead person placed in its final resting place, or perhaps being placed on an altar to be sacrificed by a figure with a spear and accompanied by another raven, or perhaps a bird being offered by another man, possibly a warrior. This might be Odin there, with his two ravens and his famous spear Gungnir, and to the left there seems to be a figure of a hanged man on a tree, which is not only a way of sacrifice to the god Odin, but also a symbol of the deity himself, since one of Odin's names is Hungadothrin, Lord of the Hanged, and also Hungathir, God of the Hanged. And there it is, in the middle of this death and sacrifice scene, the symbol so-called Valknut, or possibly Rungnisjerta, in the center of the composition, making it the most important thing that should be noticed at once. So it is true that this symbol occurs in funeral contexts. But as I have said before, the previous picture is heavily suggestive of the cult of Odin. But there are other contexts where this symbol appears that point on the exact opposite direction of the cult of Odin, or a cult linked to death and sacrifice. In conclusion, we cannot link this symbol to Odin, death and sacrifice only. There seems to be more to this symbol, and it goes far beyond the conclusions we have taken so far. So I think we must continue to study this symbol in order to bring to light the true meaning of the symbol, because it seems to me this symbol is much more complex than we originally thought.